Don't I know you, sir?
Don't believe so. I haven't been here in many years. Name's Silas Greaves.
Silas Greaves? The bounty hunter?
Used to be.
Well, what are you doing here in Abilene?
Just passing through. Got a little business to take care of.
Well, sir, it would be an honor if you would allow me to buy you a beer.
Hell, son, it would be my honor to drink it.
I'm Molly. Howdy.
I'm Dwight. That's Jack and Steve. Ben's behind the bar. Oh, I bet you got some great stories.
A couple. Any of them true?
Jack, be nice.
A few.
What about your shootout with Henry Plummer's gang in Bannock, Montana? Is that where you started as a bounty hunter? That's what it says in this here dime novel.
Don't believe everything you read in them dime novels, boy. First man I hunted was back when I was riding with Billy the Kid.
You knew Billy the Kid?
Damn right. That scrawny son of a bitch had no fear. Wouldn't back down for nobody.
I heard he collected the tin stars off any crooked lawman who crossed him.
It was a war, boy. The Lincoln County War. And Billy promised his regulators would take the life of every bastard who helped bushwhack John Tunstall.
Kid had a big chip on his shoulder and a hair trigger temper. Made him dangerous as hell. It was about 30 years ago. Billy was hiding out in an abandoned farm near Stinking Springs. I threw in with the kid because the man I had sworn vengeance on was riding with Billy's enemies. But before I tell you why I want that sumbitch dead, let me tell you what happened that day. I was heading back to the hideout when suddenly I had this funny feeling.
Funny, haha?
No, Steve. The other kind of funny.
You heard Pat. You need to stay here and keep an eye on the road.
That's not fair. We're missing all the fun.
I knew those two morons would never let me through. I had no choice.
Who's that?
Was it Pat Garrett's posse?
Oh, yeah. I heard the shots and I knew I had to move fast. Garrett and his army of deputies had surrounded the entire homestead. I decided to help Billy and the boys out a bit. So that's just what I did. As the governor of New Mexico was paying for the kid's apprehension, Garrett was able to hire every gun hand in Lincoln County.
Thank you.
the hell's Gary? Never around when you need...
with their heads cut off.
I got this.
Still, one of them reached the water tower. Not a bad idea. It would be a turkey shoot from up there. Luckily, these shooters Garrett hired weren't the sharpest tools in the shed.
Let's do this!
A lot of them were saddle tramps or sod busters or drunken drifters looking to make a few bucks.
Oh, pretty cool!
Friendly voice yelling at me from the window.
Back door! We'll cover you!
Try aiming, you idiots!
Truth be told, things weren't much better behind the house.
Watch your flank!
I cut their numbers in half. But that just made the ones that were left twice as mad. They made up for their lack of skill with a seemingly endless supply of ammo. It was a bit of a slog, but I finally fought my way around the back of the house. And like that, I was inside, none the worse for wear. I passed Dirty Dave.
Deader than a rat in a trap.
And upstairs, I found Billy and Charlie Baudry.
How about that? Huh? You like that?
Billy looked at me and said, "About time, amigo. Grab a gun and get to the window."
Wait, so you were friends with Billy the Kid?
Yeah, sort of. Anyway, we were surrounded by dozens of deputized shooters who wanted to do us harm. I'm telling you, Garrett's men were dropping like flies, but they just kept on coming. That's when Charlie got hit. "They're catching us in a crossfire," shouted Billy. "Get to the other side."
Shoot that bastard!
suckers I personally put down. It was pretty clear, even to Billy, that maybe discretion was the better part of valor.
What's that mean?
It means that it was time to cut and run.
They got a Gatling, Billy shouted. Get the horses and bring them around back. I'll draw their attention.
He directed that order at me, and I thought, why the hell do I have to do it?
Those four sons of bitches are done for!
They would have fled in my place. But I had that false sense of invincibility that many young men have. Like Jack here.
What are you saying, old man?
Jack is just joshing.
Yeah, he better be.
Mr. Graves, please continue.
Please, call me Silas, ma'am. Now, where was I?
You were heading for the barn.
Gonna make you bleed!
Like Garrett hired a whole regiment of hired guns.
Yeah, and just when I thought I was done with them, more of these hapless bastards would pop up. Finally, I had the stables within my reach. That's when I met Sheriff Pat Garrett.
I read that you went toe-to-toe with him, sir. That backstabbing bastard with that tacked-on tin star. Into a showdown.
You read that in a dime novel?
It said he showed no fear as he took your measure with eyes like a rattlesnake. In a fair fight.
Is that what that Penny Dreadful said? No, boy. That ain't what I meant when I said I met Pat Garrett. So let me start again. I finally reached those damn stables. And stepped inside, and... Last thing I heard was Garrett's voice. That's not Billy.
And go on, how did it end?
End? Boy, that was just the beginning.
So what happened? Did Garrett arrest you?
Yeah. After I came to, a bastard had clocked me with his Colt.
And
the kid surrendered. When he realized there was no getting out of there alive.
So they locked you up in Lincoln?
Indeed they did. Sentenced me to hang right along with the kid. It's important to know that I was only riding with Billy so I could find the bastard I was after. He was with John Kinney's gang. They were sworn enemies of Billy's regulators.
Why were you after him?
I owed that son of a bitch a bullet for what he had done to me and mine. Instead, all I got for myself was a goddamn death sentence. Luckily, it was right around then that I heard Billy make his move. He shot Jim Bell and a few other guards as he made his getaway. Later, they wrote that some lady friend planted a pistol for him in the privy. What the papers didn't say is that Billy helped me escape, too. My first order of business was finding a firearm. Luckily, I located Deputy Bob Ollinger's mean-ass shotgun. I saw Billy through the window, and he yelled that I should take to the rooftops to make my escape. So I did.
Anybody see Billy?
Yes, sir, a bitch shot Jim Bell!
Put down your weapon!
The kids escaped raised a huge ruckus.
Come out, you yellow bastard!
Hell yeah. That scatter gun was like a double-barreled howitzer. It could blow a man clear off his feet. You hardly had to aim the damn thing. Guards were everywhere looking for him.
You can't let the kid get away.
Some of that wood was slippery as hell. The whole town was up in arms. Suddenly, I was a fugitive.
How the hell did the kid escape?
Garrett's gonna kick our ass!
Can't have gotten before!
So that bastard you were after, what did he do?
He did me and my family a grievous harm. But I knew if I was ever gonna find him, I would need to get my ever-loving ass out of there. I tried to be stealthy and sneak my way past.
You!
But hell, if they weren't all waiting for me. Apparently, some of them thought I was Billy.
Yeah.
town somewhere.
See, me and the kid share a certain similarity in build and color. I was just glad I had Deputy Bob's mean-ass shotgun. So much lead was whizzing by my head, it was like everyone in Lincoln wanted to put me in the ground. I knew I needed to find a horse. Though I never did have a great fondness for those four-legged grass eaters. Smelly, sweaty, ungrateful beasts. We prize them too high, if you ask me.
Surrender yourself!
Was the kid while you were busy getting shot at?
Gone. And that's when it occurred to me why Billy set me free.
Leave it!
So I could be a hapless decoy and draw attention while he snuck out of town.
Boy, you are shit out of luck.
I knew if I made it out of there in one piece, no one would put a price on my head.
Because everybody in Lincoln would be dead?
No. Because they all thought I was Billy. And all that blame would fall on him. Meanwhile, Deputy Bob Ollinger was organizing a posse to put me down. He was already a mean son of a bitch, but he was doubly pissed that I stole his mean-ass shotgun. Anyway, it was me or them, and the only way forward led me straight to perdition. But the cards were dealt, and I had no choice but to play them.
We can take them!
I guess Billy. Billy save your ass, taking out Bob Olinger the way he did.
Billy didn't kill Bob.
Sure he did. He dispatched him right after he shot Deputy Bell.
No, sir. Because Bob came right up behind me, angry as hell that Billy had lit out. Hello, Bob, I said. I think you better let me go. And he says, I don't think so, boy. Not with my shotgun. So we stood there in the middle of the street, eyeball to eyeball. He intended to kill me, and I knew I had no choice but to defend myself. Killed him in a fair fight. Everybody saw I had no damn choice. Well, Lincoln got a mite depopulated that day. That Garrett gunned down Billy 3 months later, so his escape was all for naught anyway.